The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The next day, Jesus decided to go to Galilee, and he found Philip and said to him, "Follow me." Now, Philip was from Bethsaida, the city of Andrew and Peter. Philip found Nathanael and said to him, "We have found him of whom Moses in the law and also the prophets wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph." Nathanael said to him, "Can anything good come out of Nazareth?" Philip said to him, "Come and see." Jesus saw Nathanael coming to him and said to him, "Behold, an Israelite indeed, in whom is no guile." Nathanael said to him, "How do you know me?" Jesus answered him, "Before Philip called you, when you were under the fig tree, I saw you." Nathanael answered him, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus answered him, "Because I said to you, I saw you under the fig tree, do you believe? You shall see greater things than these." And he said to him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, you will see heaven opened and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord. My dear sisters, we have a beautiful passage about the vocation of the first disciples according to St. John's Gospel. A light begins and then it is responsible for some more candles to be lit. First of all, it was John the Baptist who pointed out to Jesus the Lord, "Behold the Lamb of God," and two of the disciples followed Jesus. "What do you want?" Jesus asked them. They responded, "Where do you stay?" Jesus said, "Come and see." So many congregations have this come and see program. They went and saw Jesus, stayed with him. What was the response? One of the disciples, Andrew, came and told Peter, "Come, I have seen the Messiah. You also come and see." And today's gospel begins with Philip, Andrew, from whose village Philip is brought to Jesus. And Philip tells Nathanael, and Nathanael is brought to Jesus. The first lesson right at the beginning of this year for us is knowing Jesus, experiencing Jesus, and bringing somebody else to Jesus. Nobody should say because of us they were spoiled, they lost the way. How like a chain reaction, one after the other is brought to Jesus. And Jesus knows us, the second lesson, in all our sincerity. He tells Nathanael, "I saw you under the fig tree." Jesus tells Nathanael, "He is a man without guile." Jesus knows that Nathanael speaks from the heart. Can anything good come out of Nazareth? And Nathanael is touched. And then he responds to Jesus with an act of faith. And the Lord says, "I will show greater things than these. Trust me, follow me, give yourself to me." Let us also learn from Nathanael to be spontaneous, sincere, people without guile, and trusting the promise of the Lord and following him till the very end. I can't leave out today's beautiful first reading. We can't omit none of these words. Once we experience the love of the Lord tells us not to love him in return, but to love our brothers and sisters in return. If you are conscious of the love of God for you, you have to manifest it through loving others, encouraging them, being patient with them, giving your time to them, sharing your talents with them, And finally, it also says, if Jesus died for you, you should be prepared to die for others. Let us not take anybody's life out of them. Sometimes some parents say, this child will take my life out of me. This person is there in this institution, in this community, to give her life for the congregation, for the community. This is what people should say. It's not enough. I am so much edified whenever you spend time here in adoration, in prayer, morning prayer, evening prayer, other spiritual exercises. That must be manifest in your life of charity, kindness, being ready to any work, especially when people are in need. Jesus says, realizing my love for you must animate you to give yourself totally for the people in need. That's what in today's first reading we hear. And then another passage is very, very shocking. Sometimes we think that we are not murderers. There are murderers in jail. But according to today's first reading, whoever hates is a murderer. Sometimes we hate people from the heart. We don't manifest. We say, good morning, Father. Good evening, Father. Maybe if we are hating in the heart, then we are murderers. Apparently somebody understands you as his friend or her friend. But then everyone who hates is a murderer in the tradition of Cain, today's gospel says. We should not be murderers. We should realize God's love for us constantly through our lives of prayer. And then we should manifest that love in a life of charity, concern, compassion, being blessings to others. During this season, I repeated this point so many times. And you also heard it from me so many times in this place of grace. What is it? Our moments of prayer is moment of conception. Our life of love during the day is moment of giving birth. This is not my idea. This is the thought manifest by the first person who created the Christmas crib, St. Francis of Assisi. Moments of prayer, participating in the Eucharist. In our prayer, community prayer, in our personal meditation, all these are moments of conception. So many people conceive, but they don't give birth. We have to give birth throughout the day by life of kindness, charity, compassion, understanding, sacrifice. Let us not only conceive through praying and listening to the word of God and meditating. Let us be people who also do give birth to Jesus. Again and again we hear during the Christmas season, for you a child is born, or for us a child is born. That is not enough. For every believer, there is another message. In you, Jesus must be born. In you, the child must be born. May Jesus be born every day in us and through us. Amen.